evening, everyone. Welcome to Tuesday, March 29th meeting of the Board of Selectmen. Ask everyone to please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everyone. Start with approval of warrants. I entertain a motion to approve the wire warrant for March 22nd, expense warrant for the 23rd, expense warrant for the 29th, and payroll warrant for the 29th.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second.
Any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Announcements. The Historical Commission is seeking members to serve on their board. It's a good opportunity for residents interested in the town's heritage and preserving its rich history. The Advisory Committee is also seeking members to fill vacant seats on the board. Those wishing to serve on either board, please send a letter of interest to Selectmen, S-E-L-E-C-T-M-E-N, at Brookfield, M-A, all one word, .us, or simply call the Selectmen's office at 508-867-2930, extension 10, and Karen will get you in touch with who you need to be in touch with. Mr. Wallenin, District Aide to Senator Ann Goby, will be holding office hours at the Brookfield Town Hall from 2 to 3 p.m. Wednesday, April 20th. All are welcome. Any other announcements? Hearing none. Anybody wish to address the board this evening? Welcome, sir.
Evening.
Good evening.
Got a couple topics tonight. I talked about that electronic voting machine, right?
Mm-hmm. Last night, yep.
What about trying to get more attendance at the meetings? That's what I'm trying to do. Is there any way you would consider changing Friday night meeting to another day?
We've had that discussion.
Friday night's a horrible thing.
Ever since I've been involved in town government, since probably 12 years ago, we've always talked about different days. We've held different days. I'm not opposed to any, but it just seems that Friday works.
Friday doesn't work.
We've tried it, David, even all the years I've been around. We've tried Monday nights, we've tried Tuesdays, we've tried Thursdays.
I think the only thing we really haven't tried is a Saturday. The town of Hardwick does.
The Hardwick, and they,
on a Saturday?
And they have a good turnout on a Saturday, too. See, in between, I think they take a break and they have lunch. So,
no, he moves it along pretty quickly.
And they do a lunch and everything, so.
I'm used to Saturdays.
Saturdays?
Westminster was Saturdays. Yeah.
Well, I'm just saying,
they have it during the day, though, up there in Hardwick.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Even the board meetings.
10 to noon. Pardon me.
No, I'm sorry. Okay. No one meets any boards or committees don't even meet on Fridays in the town.
Tuesday night, Dave. Been doing this for 5 years. Yeah. This is a good turnout.
I understand that, but I'm talking about the annual town meeting.
We're not opposed to more attendance, different date. It's even in our bylaw, isn't it? It's a Friday.
Friday.
So it's
is
our,
it in the bylaw then?
Yeah.
Someone said it wasn't.
It's definitely in the bylaw. Yes, it is. It's in the bylaw.
For Fridays?
The first Friday after. Hold it though now with a lot of your new rules. You don't have to hold it the first Friday anymore.
So that's the precedent.
We're not beholden to a Friday, no. But I'm just footnoting the fact that even in the bylaws, the town voted to meet on a Friday.
So would anyone consider trying to change it to another day?
We have considered it. We've discussed it every single town meeting.
We have tried it, David, and it doesn't work.
It doesn't affect the attendance?
Nope. Mondays, I can remember. Excuse me, I can remember having them on. We tried Mondays one time for a while, and I can remember having to go out and ask people to come in for the meeting so we could get our.
What we're going to do is we're going to pick a controversial subject.
Well, I was going to say the only thing that gets people in is big ticket money items.
Yeah, that's the only thing. Yeah.
So how would we go about getting it changed if we wanted to do it?
The selectmen set the meeting.
Yeah. Make a recommendation.
Would you consider it?
I consider anything.
Yeah.
Friday night's horrible. Okay, so anyway, I'll explain that electronic when I get more stuff on the voting.
You're going to reach out to the...
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. The one I'm talking about has got 125 buttons right now for 3,200. And it has a screen for the moderator. Everything will just show up on your screen. You know, you'll give so many seconds for everybody to vote, and then no one can vote after that. The buttons go back to neutral again. So it's a pretty good system.
Have you discussed anything with Mike about the company that he...
No, that's what Steve's referring to now. Yeah. I'm gonna talk to him about it, though. He thought it was a good idea to do something along those lines.
I think it is.
Worth running.
you know, that everybody can, you know, everybody can vote the way they want to vote, and they won't, you know, have somebody looking over their shoulder, like, you know, why you vote that way or whatever, you know. And I think that's pretty critical at these meetings. I just want to do a follow-up on the driveway on 16 East Main. Clarence showed up, and everything got resolved. He actually helped out for a year, an hour and a half, 2 hours.
Probably an hour or so.
No, it was about an hour and a half. I was there. One of the water commissioners, Bob Barnes, showed up. He helped out. Bob Wilson came by, and he helped out. Brought some tools over. Clarence asked him to get some tools.
Yeah, I didn't bring my pick.
We ran into some rock, so I think that thing has been resolved. But the driveway still hasn't been fixed by the highway.
He was going to come back once things dried up again.
So when is that going to...
Well, if it stopped raining. Yesterday was rain. Last week was rain, so...
Oh, are they still working up in the corner?
Yeah. Oh, yes, definitely, on Weber Road.
Okay, so when can... I expect it to be smoothed out and his, whatever the rocks are doing.
I'll ask again. I mean, we get rain at the end of this week as well, so I'll ask.
What, Friday?
Thursday or Friday, we're supposed to get rain again. So, anyway, but he did promise to do that once it dried out again. He just didn't want to create any mud or anything like that.
All right, so I just want to say thanks to you for helping me out and the other two, but I want the driveway fixed.
Yep.
And I would hope that something can be done with these type of actions.
And with all the water.
To the highway department when something like that kind of activity and those kind of actions have got to stop. Do you agree?
I understand there was what had happened and saw both sides, so we certainly helped with both sides.
Okay. So it's up to you three to make sure that type of activity doesn't continue on. Those are bad actions. I mean, it's a small town here. We should all get along here, you know. So.
Mr. Cleveland had his hand up.
So it was my understanding that the homeowner would take care of the driveway to the road, have it paved, and then that's what the money is deposits for. So the town could come back to make sure that it doesn't
but
create
this,
a situation.
This wasn't under that set of rules. That the rules changed just after this particular permit.
And it wasn't even that issue.
Yeah. That wasn't the issue anyway.
And it's not an agenda item, it's public access, so you can continue, Mr. Holcraft.
Okay. The water coming out of this driveway comes from next door.
Yeah, we had the discussion, and hopefully through this it's been alleviated.
It's working, right?
Yeah. I mean, it wasn't a big to-do, I mean, you know. So, okay, so I'll be expecting to get it fixed, you know, maybe this week or...
I hope, or next week.
Okay.
I'll speak to him.
All right, good. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
So we'll consider about that Friday night.
Long ways down the road before we start talking about town meeting. But.
Okay, right, cool. Thanks.
Anybody else wish to address the board this evening? Mr. Holcraft requested that we change the town meeting from a Friday night to a different night or morning or... We just kicked the bucket. I'm picking up the bucket and bringing it to the discussion for setting the town meeting. Item number one, I would ask Mr. Jay to please join us, if
he
could. And while he's making his way up, if everybody out there listening remembers Mr. Jay coming before the board, it seems like yesterday, but unfortunately it was several months ago. He's been very busy getting signs, not only the conceptual part done, but actually making them. You have a picture, we have a picture. So wherever Sharon feels comfortable for people out in TV land. Hold it still, am I shaking?
Not bad.
Not too bad.
Okay, I don't drink caffeine either. But Mr. J has very, very generously, and it's not even only Mr. J, it's Mrs. J as well, the powerhouse always stands far in the back, propping us up. But I'd like to thank both of you publicly. That's why we asked you to come out. For people out there that are listening as well, all the old Brookfield, Welcome to Brookfield signs will be replaced, removed and replaced with this new template with beautiful, I believe there were Gothic posts as well. All maintenance free and all at the expense of Mr. and Mrs. J. So I will turn the floor over to the other two selectmen.
I had talked to Mr. J just before the meeting, and I thanked him and told him how grateful I was to him. And I said, the pictures are beautiful, but he says, they're not as nice as the sign. He was thankful to me, Elizabeth, very much.
Well, I appreciate it very much. I sat here, I guess now several weeks ago, and discussed changing of the signage in town. The signs that are there are very well weather-worn by this time, and obviously continued congratulations to the group that put them up in the beginning. But in my opinion, it became time to change the signs and to update them. So getting involved and then some conversation with others in town, decided to do that. Looked around locally, ended up down in Hopedale having the signs made. And the material that we found to use is called sign foam. It sounds a little cheap by saying that, but it really isn't. It's a replacement for wood. It looks like wood. It's a synthetic foam product with a high density urethane. It's easier to maintain, resistant to bugs and insects. Water resistant, not warp, withstands temperatures minus 30 to 220 degrees, accepts high quality paint, and it's acrylic on the sign. And they wouldn't guarantee it, but told me that it should last 25 plus years maintenance free. And having said that, I ended up with a small can of paint that in case something goes wrong, and I'll have to turn the can of paint over to Steve or somebody else to maintain whatever needs to happen. The sign locations are basically going to be the same. One down Route 148 South at Tantaskwa, the folks who own that piece of property welcome the new sign, and it'll stay in the same location. Route 148 North at the North Brookfield line, the same location as the previous sign. Route 9 East, just east of the former Carmelis restaurant, it's in the same location. The folks that purchased Carmelis told me that we could move it closer to town if we choose to on their property. I don't see that necessary, but the problem with the Brookfield, East Brookfield site is the fact that there was a lot of landscaping that now has to be done there. It hasn't been taken care of for years. Yeah. And that includes taking down two or three dead trees and generally cleaning up the property. It's going to require just a little bit of work there. And we now go to Route 9 West. We're going to relocate the sign from where it currently is, and we're going to move it up to the just west of the cemetery. There's a nice little piece of property where old West Brookfield Road used to be, and the sign will go in there, and I think it's going to be a much better vantage point for the sign and its location. That's been approved to go into that area. And I guess that's basically all. The signs are at home. I hang around with my bad back. Three or four or five people have volunteered. I can use all the help I can get. But the old signs are going to be coming out. The new signs will be going in as soon as we can gather a little group in which to do that. And things are pretty well done after that. I guess the base of the signs, once the weather gets a little bit better, will be decorated with perennials or some such thing to kind of pretty it up a little bit more than it is. But basically, that's the new signs. I'm very happy to do it. I enjoy Brookfield and the community spirit that the town has given me, and I'll look to the camera and ask for any other future community efforts that you may be interested in. Call me. I'll join you and we'll do it.
Thank you again, sir.
Thank you again.
I appreciate it.
And thank the missus as well.
Yeah, I'm gonna pass this on to Steve, it's, can be public, but.
Thank you, sir.
The only other comment, I guess it can be public, is that some people are now calling me the new sign man for Brookfield.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
Bite my tongue a little bit, no, yeah, but that's a good thing.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
Thank you again, sir.
Thank you.
We appreciate even more.
Trail is already out.
New sign guy. The green, well, there is yellow in there, so we're gonna call you the yellow sign guy now. Green sign guy. Item number two, sign special use permit. I will entertain a motion to to approve the request from the Blackstone Valley Bassmasters to use Quabog for 10 vehicles on July 23rd, starting at 5 a.m. to 1:30 p.m.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
I forget who signs this. Clarence, you do, don't you?
Yep, I do. I do. Pen's warmed up.
Item number three, bridge dedication discussion. Linda, did you want this on?
No.
Did we talk about this?
I sent an email just so that we could start to think about, talk about that weekend and just to make sure.
We talked about it Thursday morning. Did you get correspondence of that?
I didn't.
Because the memorial committee, we met Wednesday evening.
Right, yep.
We talked about it also.
Yeah, so I just wanted to make sure we were all talking.
The biggest highlights was the bench that it was a go.
Yeah.
There were a couple people that I would like to see get involved in it. We made that mention.
Mm-hmm.
Linda can get back to that.
Yeah.
I did see action down there with Mr. Clark and Mr. Murray over the weekend, I think,
yep.
Saturday.
Yep.
So
I stopped and chatted with them as
well. Probably scout in that area.
Yep.
The discussion of who would actually dedicate the bridge came up. I guess the committee had talked about Senator Brewer. Me, personally, I'd like to see our governor or lieutenant governor do it.
I
think that would be a privilege to the town of Brookfield.
And we asked the office of
Senator Gobey.
Of Senator Gobey, and they have not. I asked Tyler, he said it's going to take a while, but he will come back with an answer.
Yep. Well, that's my next question, because the email that I saw from him was asking us if we wanted to request it from the office or they wanted to. So has a request actually been made?
Yes, a request. Yes,
can you just follow up?
I asked him to request it.
All right.
And then we also had emailed Senator Gobey's office to find out just what the dedication, just what the signs we're going to see and we say, and we want to see a picture of them.
Did you get a copy back?
No, we haven't gotten anything back yet.
Okay.
And then we talked about, you know, different things. We'd like to have, see if we can get the Marine color guard down here, you know, because Mr. Murray is a Marine.
Absolutely.
And then Steve had also mentioned it would be nice to even have a state police color guard also. Down
they're
here
available,
it.
Sure.
And then one of the members had something to do with, she knows the band director very well at Tantascwa, and she was saying it would be nice if we could, you know, get them to come down if they weren't involved with anything. And then her daughter does taps, and so that's Mrs. Pratt's daughter, and she said she'd come down and do the taps.
Oh, great.
And, you know, it'd be nice, I know Mr. Brewer, Senator Brewer wants to be involved with it very much also.
Great.
So, and then I suggested too, because I had gone to one in Barry last year on the same weekend, and I mean, it was run by their VFW, you know, we don't have one down here, but it was a nice ceremony, and then they had a wreath made up, and they had the family drop the wreath over the bridge, which was very nice, and then they had the gun salute, and it was very, very nice ceremony.
So you have that order of service?
Yeah.
Available to you. That was one of my main concerns, is to make sure we had an order of service that.
Oh yes, we did. The memorial committee
did
it, and then we then I talked to Steve about it, and he had some more to it.
Okay, because from the other piece, as the Murrays arrive in town, the church wanted to do something, and the minister's available if that's something that you need.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's another thing.
If you need that.
Yeah, and then I also suggested it would be nice to have. You know, Mrs. Murray brought down a car because that's what they did with the family too.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And then somebody mentioned Peter Mazuza's old car over on, and we could ask
fun.
Peter to do it. So we thought it would
be
something
fun.
Nice to do.
Yeah. No, that was as simple as, I just wanted to make sure we were talking.
And we thought 10 o'clock in the morning.
Right, yep. Good plan.
Yeah.
Good. Beautiful.
Yep.
Item number four, appointments. Before we appoint, I included a copy of the charge for the Master Plan Implementation Committee. What we found when we did this, I think it was around 3 years ago, a lot of these individuals had no interest in serving on this, thus the hard time finding somebody. So I'm going to entertain a motion in the committee membership portion, the first paragraph, change this to the MPIC shall consist of 5 members, adding a period, removing, no, not there, adding a period after Brookfield.
Mm-hmm.
So the MPIC shall consist of 5 members who are residents of Brookfield, period.
Mm-hmm.
And delete and members of the boards listed below completely.
Right.
Also remove in lieu of current member, the board may appoint delegate to represent its interests to the community, not to the committee.
Okay.
And then obviously remove the 5 individuals below that we just struck.
Okay.
Well, we do have Maureen LePat that is tentatively chairing, so that...
But that it'll still be a resident,
yeah.
1 of
right.
5.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Remove that,
okay.
Yep.
The onus,
yep,
and just make it easier.
Yep.
Do we want to make it an ad hoc committee of the planning board, or should we make it just remove that altogether?
Well, we've talked that it would be an ad hoc.
All
looking sure. to Sharon and the planning board to be mentors towards this committee, to kind of work in concert with one another.
So we're okay with?
I think so.
Can I ask Sharon, is your committee, do they go along with this?
Please.
Okay.
Yeah, we've had good communication.
Okay.
Right, so I will entertain that motion to edit the charges discussed.
I will make that motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Karen, those are the changes.
Yep, I got them in my pocket.
With that being said, we have 2 current members already appointed, I believe, correct?
That's correct. Mr. Mm-hmm. Taft and Mr. LePat.
So those dates, and that'll be nice, so.
And we try to spread it out.
I was going to say that's where we're at, because
yeah.
it's not in the charge of spreading it to 5 years, so they all don't end right
yeah.
at 5
yeah,
years.
Yeah, that's okay. how we tried to work okay. it. So, that
so I'm going to entertain a motion to appoint Mr. Is it Levine or Levine?
Levine.
Yeah.
Doctor.
Dr. Levine.
Dr. Levine.
With the term to expire June 30th, 2017. Mr.
Feniff.
Is it Feniff?
Yes.
Feniff, yes.
Feniff.
With a term to expire June 30th, 2019. Mm-hmm. And Ms. Wellman with a term to expire June 30th, 2019.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion?
Nope.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And I'd like to thank them all for coming forward to serve on this committee.
I'd like to thank Mr. Snyder as well for
and Mr. Snyder
getting
as well.
It going.
Yeah.
Now, what is the other one that I had?
CIPC, that yeah. we talked about last
yeah.
night, the Capital Improvement Planning
Capital
Committee.
Planning Committee.
Thinking on the way here as well, does this board want to readdress the change in bylaw of melding? Because the CIPC is in the bylaws. We have to have that committee.
Mm.
Do we want to try to melt? We've tried it twice. Do we want to try to meld it again into the advisory committee and make a finance committee?
I would
like to see that.
Yes,
that
I would.
So I have the charge that I worked with
yeah.
with a couple other people. It was around 3 years ago. I literally, all we did was take some language out that was just nonsensical and melded both charges into one. We did add, because we had an issue with the finance committee,
mm-hmm.
That the selectmen have the power to remove individuals as well, which we had, by town council's opinion, we already have that ability,
mm-hmm.
but if it's in black and white, it wouldn't be a fight. That was the biggest contention
yeah.
on the floor about that, because they thought they were overstepping our power, which town council argues we already have.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll get Karen to pull that, or if she can't find it, I'll find my draft from 3 years ago. Disseminate it, and then if we
yeah.
have to go to the bylaw committee, because I know Ms. Grabowski wanted to work on it. I think Mr. Cook had his own version as well. It's keep it simple.
Yeah. Just keep it simple, yeah.
Okay.
Because I feel we need to get that going.
So we'll put that, can we put that on the next agenda?
There you go.
But the way the master plan implementation committee's going to work, or their plan, their charge is to go through the current document, see where we are, what's been done, what's not done, work with the various committees to understand where we are, and then go from there.
Beautiful. Item number 5, wage authorization. Entertain a motion to approve the wage authorization for the transfer station for Mr. Halbrook for the rate of $10 per hour.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Item number 6, vote to accept the Mass Historical Grant. We discussed this at our last meeting 2 weeks ago. We got the formal letter, and the chair of the Historical Commission is here. Would you like to join us for ceremonial purpose? Or
this is as much ceremonial as
anything. What I'm going to do is pass that to Mr. Snyder.
Right. Well, this is the original, exactly. Yep.
I let everyone know last week about the meeting, but I don't know what
you're. But that's okay.
The floor is yours, sir.
I think the important thing is to recognize that we did in fact receive notification that we did in fact or were selected for the additional work at the campground, something that we need to work between now and hopefully July to pick a contractor and move forward with it. And I just felt it important, because of the language of the letter that we received, that we just more formally than anything else, mm-hmm. just accept that we're going to accept and move on with this activity. That was as simple as it was. And the committee must be pleased that we're moving in this direction.
Very.
So I'll
ready to get going, yeah?
I don't know. You're gonna find out.
We have to go to a meeting.
in Boston?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. There is a meeting in Boston that will be scheduled in May. And that talks about the provisions of the contract and how to go about contracting for the service that we need.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And you obviously want somebody from Historical
Co. I would appreciate, well,
I'll, you'll let me know when.
Yeah, we'll go together. Whoever can join me, it would be terrific. Okay. But again, I'm listed as a program manager, so I'll continue to manage as we have with the support with Kermit and all the support that we have.
It's turned into a great project for the town of Brookfield. We're finally recognizing, it might, and I'm just one person, the travesty that happened down there, regaining the property back to the rightful owners of town and, you know, the heritage and preserving it potentially through this. I think we're doing a great thing.
Yeah, we'll be a lot smarter by the end of the summer, hopefully. So with that, I'd make a motion that we approve the acceptance of the $17,500 grant from Mass Historical.
I'll make that motion.
Did you want to make it? Second it?
I made it. Did you second this one for me?
Yeah, I'll
thank
second
you.
It. Okay.
All right.
I will entertain discussion. Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
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 Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, yes, sir.
Can I ask a question?
You ask as many as you like.
Jim, from dealing with people at UMass, is that correct? Who's kind of.
They gave.
Us
yeah, they guided us, but we actually have to formally bid the thing.
Is there any chance we could get them to come out and do a site walk?
He's volunteered to do that. Now that this is all in place, he's going to make a road trip. This is Eric Johnson. He's volunteered to make a road trip this way, and hopefully before we go to Boston and know what we're talking about. But yes,
and the state has done a walk with us about 3 or 4 years ago as well. That's documented with Mr. Kucher's documentation.
This is in reference to like the survey.
Yep.
He can provide us with some guidance. To let us know how we're doing and what we might need to do more, I think would be.
Right. He's been coaching us over the phone, and I've been sharing that with Kermit and Bruce. And both Kermit and Bruce asked that could he stop by, and I asked him to do that. And he's trying to plan it within his agenda to stop by.
Great.
Yep.
Thank you.
Good. Thanks.
Lois.
Yes. See, we were on time every time, Lois. We're quick. See what happens with your chairman?
Would you like to add anything?
Just go all over it again.
No.
Do I add anything else? Huh?
Would you like to add anything in regards to the whole process? No?
No.
Thank you for your involvement.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
And I heard Mrs. Plum just became the chairman, and I'd like to congratulate her. I know she'll do a wonderful job.
I would've done my hair if I know.
You look beautiful.
Thank you, Carol.
Okay, and you'll let me know about the meeting in Boston?
Yes, yep, super. Thanks a million.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies.
Thank you, Lois.
Say hi to the husbands. Item number seven, discuss town hall renovations. We met, has it already been almost 2 weeks ago? In regards to this?
Yes.
Specifically for this. We also met with the advisory committee yesterday to start the conversation, looking down the road of what we want to do with this building. It continues to be unanimous vote by the Board of Selectmen to move forward with said plan through several phases. There has been a lot of contention in regards to the money allocated for ADA accessibility issues for the bathroom and thresholds and whatnot. Again, I reiterate, I've met with Tantascwa. They're on board with helping us for the thresholds, and they are on board next year for helping us with petitions in this project with the sophomore class. For those that are skeptical about allowing, and it's not hidden, we're not doing secret squirrel meetings. Everything's been televised, everything's been documented through meetings, through votes. We've sought town council, you remember we've been talking about this before the last special town meeting, because we wanted to allocate the money and switch it to a different vote, but we sought town council's opinion. They said that the intent was there. The intent is to bring an ADA accessible bathroom into this building. That's the intent. After that meeting last week, I heard a lot of contention from residents in town of moving forward with this plan. So I wanted to bring this board together. I'm glad we met with the advisory committee, because I thought they didn't take a vote. We had a little bit of a discussion, but it sounded like the majority of that board was on board.
Yeah, they seem to be.
With this plan. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if before we move forward with taking that $50,000 and turning it into a bathroom and, you know, putting us on a road down, you know, which could potentially be $1 million to upgrade this building, do we want to have a public hearing and have people come in and say yay or nay?
Well, I think we have one step ahead of the public hearing, is that Bill Simpson has in fact set up a meeting for next Tuesday. I can't be there because I'm in Boston again.
With Mr. Scanlon?
With Mr. Scanlon. And so what I do, just for our talking purposes tonight, in the architect's study, there were four phases. The first phase just happens to be $50,000, mm-hmm. and it was all to do with accessibility. Yeah. The second phase was $880,000. It had a lot to do with more accessibility.
Well, I just want to back up to that first phase.
Yep.
That's where we got the amount for the town vote.
Exactly.
Yeah. And all that $50,000 was going to do was fix a couple thresholds and turn that one toilet, one urinal into a pedestal that a wheelchair can get under,
right,
and a one toilet stall.
Right.
So we're not talking about a new woman's bathroom that's going to fit into that plan, but in my opinion, we can get all that ADA thing projects in plus a new bathroom under that $50,000.
Exactly.
Yes.
And what I had, and I demonstrated to you, a caution on my part, because the second phase, which included the restrooms as you have on the design, and just happens that the elevator's there as well, within the next phase was to the estimate within the study was $880,000. What happens is, if you just go that far with that project, what happens is we found money as we were working with Mass Historical. We found money within their preservation bricks and mortar projects that you could get 30%. And what was different in this year's edition, which will now continue, is that they will fund 30% of a larger project for accessibility, including elevators. So it's how do you go capture these funds?
We have to start the project before.
Yeah. And so what I was suggesting when we talked is that we'd be cautious as we move into this next phase, because if the hardware for the elevator was estimated in that study at $131,000, that doesn't say installation, the wiring, and all the rest. But the reality is, if you made that the 30%, or you made the whole installation of the elevator 30% of the larger project, you have the opportunity to capture grant money. further, you have the opportunity to look to other grants like CBDG, mm-hmm. so that in fact, where something would be in, to the tune of $900,000 for all of these things, you don't have to fund it, you don't have to do all of it, but if you were to take an approach where you wanted to grab as much grant funding as you could, you then see where you land as far as what portion the town would have to come up with. To do that, to the kind of gun goes off, is that it wouldn't be, it would be to this a special town meeting later in the year to decide whether or not you wanted to go forward with that or not, but you'd be into 17 and 18 with the actual activities of this, at least.
Yeah, and it again, we've had this discussion, mm-hmm. this is what I do for a living. When yep. I came on, I want to renovate this town mm-hmm. hall, I want to get a police yeah. station, police mm-hmm. station's done, now it's time for this. We couldn't really do anything over there because it was a new building, prevailing wage, all the, but we can mm-hmm. get Tantasco in here and manage that. Yep. And we've proven with the fire, and this is a broken record to us, but yep. we're adjusting the people out there.
Right.
We have a history of showing we can do this. And if we can get a $50,000 roof for $10,000 with Tantasqua and the leadership of the board, we can get this done. And we're talking the five-year plan. We're talking, to me, my mind, well under $1 million.
And I think it's how do you break these up?
It's definitely palatable. But my whole issue right now is if there's such contention of not wanting to touch this building at all, I would rather take the money, get that small bathroom ADA compliant, fix the doors, and walk away and be done with it.
I think that's that's short-sightedness.
Well, it's not short-sightedness because if the town doesn't want to fund, we've just put a bathroom in an assessor's office with no, that is long-term. I don't think it's short-sightedness because we'll have it's almost like building a house and getting one room done and not being able to move mm-hmm. into it.
I miss it.
Because if we do this bathroom, to me, in my mind, we're beholden to finish this plan.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
But if the town does not want to do this, we're just 3 people out of 3,000. If the town doesn't want to do this, we should only just do this bathroom and be done with it. And that's where I'm at. But yeah. Me, my vote is to do this with our plan.
So, and again, getting back to the public hearing and not or when. And what I would only say is to have the data available to understand what grants and grant funding is available so that when you put a big number up that people understand that there's places to go to get the money that's not in their pocket, be a few dollars out of their pocket eventually, but where are the dollars available to them so that we could then honestly go to the...
That would be all, but are you guys interested in holding a public hearing? And as far as I'm concerned, we live in a republic. We're not a democracy, we're a republic. But that would be the most democratic process. It's an up or down vote. We literally take a vote at the end of that meeting.
Sure.
Win a new town hall, no's, we stop and we're done. We renovate the bathroom, we move on with life.
That'd be fine with me.
Yeah. If this is what you want to do,
I want to do this. But
to see that done also.
But the contention that I heard, it wasn't the Board of Selectmen is doing this. It's Stephen Comtois is doing this, and that hurts.
No, and it's the three of us. We've discussed it.
Yeah, and you got to go find extra. I mean, we are where we are with what it costs us to run this town, mm-hmm. and yes, we understand. At the same time, there's other people that you can work with, and you need to find out if those people will work with you.
Well, I'm going to tell you, the biggest asset and the proudest I am of being a selectman is finally getting Tantasqua through these doors.
Yeah.
They were good, even like they came in here, they did all the labor when we put up all the security cameras, did all of it, and they've done a very good job.
Well, I think it's a great opportunity. Yeah, to your work of getting a sophomore class in here. You get a sophomore class, by the time they're seniors, they will see the benefit of their work.
And I taught at Tantasqua, mm-hmm. I've taught at Bay Path, and I to this day, I'm friends with people on Facebook that I've had for, I actually employed two of them after I was done. And they still go around, they say, remember what we did there, and they'll drive around. You're going to have people that are going to walk into this building 20 years later and say, I did this.
That's
it's unbelievable. And that's the best part of being a teacher, in my opinion.
So it's worth, we need to get the Scanlon feedback, and then it would be time for the town meeting, or for the public hearing.
So when is he meeting now?
Next Tuesday.
Next Tuesday.
Yeah.
So at our next meeting, we'll discuss a potential date
and
location.
I'm working with Bill on this. This is a draft. Working with Bill to put dollars and timeline together so it's more accurate than the study.
It's probably,
Do we want to meet in this room for a public hearing, or do we want to go to the school? You think it's going to be a large group?
No, I'd meet here.
I'd meet here.
I think it might be a bigger group than the turf issue. This room is pretty full on the turf issue.
Great. Then we'll reschedule.
I think this room would be big enough.
All right, so Karen, can you put that on the next agenda, please?
Yeah.
Definitely. Can you come up to the table for the mic, please? Thank you.
The advisory board didn't condone or put down the plans. Mm-hmm. They didn't. It was not. We didn't even discuss it.
But we we did discuss it, and
But the three that I polled last night, after I got when I got home, I called to see what they thought, and three of them said absolutely not. They're not against what you're trying to do here with the bathrooms. They're against the plans that you presented. They're totally opposed to them.
Then they're I'm saying that breathes to my point is that if they're against the bathroom, they're against this project
they want to have a couple nice bathrooms in here, and they want to have a couple more offices in here. This is what I'm hearing out there, but they're not ready. They don't like the plans that are the ones you showed last night. That's what everybody's saying. They're not happy.
See, and that I disagree, because I heard two or three people in that meeting saying these are great plans. And we can't.
We're going to discuss it further.
Yeah, and that's what we asked. But we can't. You have to understand. We cannot split this room up into two or three offices and another bathroom unless we have upstairs. We just can't do it.
Well, that's where the contention starts. I don't think a lot of people want this room chopped up. I'm just, that's what I'm hearing.
The town's getting bigger. Those offices are getting smaller.
Yeah. And those plans, they don't have any dimensions on them, do they?
I think the one in the office at a scale.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The one you presented last night couldn't see any measurements.
A couple of the words are missing too, like the existing bathroom, the elevation.
Right. So I mean that's another
but
thing.
The original plans are in the Selectmen's office. That's what we ran copies of, and that is to scale.
But I'm just saying, where the contention is, people want the bathrooms and they want something done here, but I don't think they want to go to that extent. Is what I'm.
Of the entire town hall renovated. Mm-hmm.
I'm just talking about the plans that are presented, that everyone I've talked to with the plans that you presented, mm-hmm. they're not saying it's you, they're just saying the plans. The plans they're not happy with. I'm not saying it's Steve Comptoir. It's the plans that you three have presented they're not happy with. So I've talked to at least 25 people on it, and the ones that do know what's going on like the plans.
To be fair, those three people are the best poll because they saw the plans. The other 25 that you have to talk to, they have idea.
No, they have not.
No, they don't have.
But not just the other ones, some of the town workers have seen them, and they're not happy with them either. So, but you're going to have a public hearing, and I think that's sure. Great.
Yeah.
I talked to one of the town employees because I heard that was one of the issues. I gave them a set of plans. And they said, I don't care what happens, just get a decent bathroom in here.
Right.
Two bathrooms.
Yeah.
I just came out of the mouth with a decent bathroom in here.
Yep. To work the plan, you basically lose a third of this room to work to the plan.
Well, you lose all of this room. This becomes a selectman's office, it was a assessor's office, and a men's bathroom.
But again, you can phase the bathrooms.
Well, the bathroom would be the first phase, and then this stretch, these three rooms would be the second phase.
Mm-hmm.
And temporarily, we talked about making the assessors over in the kitchen.
Well, that's it is what it is. It's not heavy planning. It doesn't involve trailers in the back.
Yeah, and I think that's one of the problems with a few of them. They still think that we should maintain the kitchen.
See, that's when you have your public hearing, then you can go over all this detail, exactly what you're going to do, and the timeline, too. I mean...
Yeah. But I would also like to be able to go out and find out who's got grant money.
Right.
I
understand that, but that's not the issue that I'm hearing out there is the plans. People don't like those plans.
Mm-hmm. We've had so many plans drawn up.
Right.
We just can't keep putting money out there to, have more plans. And we thought that this one, agreed on it. We thought this one was the best.
And Dave, that's the same could be said about that police station. There were several plans, several locations for that. We got it done. We stayed with one plan. You still, to this day, are going to have people saying that that's too small, that's too big, I don't like the layout. You're going to have those people.
I was on the police building committee and a couple of them, and we were in agreeance to having a police station, but not for the prices. We started out at $3-4 million, then it came down, and then it was big, and everyone says, no, we're not going to do it. We voted it down a couple times, and when it got down to a nice small building, efficient, beautiful building, everybody was on board.
Not everybody, if you remember that vote, not everybody. That was a Taj Mahal.
I'm just saying the majority, a lot of people still aren't happy with it. Yeah. I was in there today, I went to again today.
It's a beautiful building.
It is, it's a nice
building. And we needed it, but what I'm saying is, if we didn't take all that time and keep all the people that got involved and said it's too much money, it's too big, and it finally everybody came together slowly, it took time. But we got something that's good enough.
The first plan, second, third, fourth plan
on that police station was no good.
What I'm going to argue is a determination. If you determine to do it, then you can do it. Right. Our biggest asset in this building right now, I'm going to argue all day, is Tantasco's availability.
That's fine as long as you get the people on board and they're all, you know, most of them are with the plans. I'm just hearing the plans.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
But you're hearing they have no idea what the plans are.
Some of them that I did talk to definitely know what's going on.
And that's where
maybe 15 of the people I talked to don't know.
They just know
in general what they're hearing.
That's why we have a public hearing and listen to them.
Right. And I think that's a great idea. But just like the police station, I mean, when they first started out, it's going to be a monster. It's going to cost us $3-4 million. And everybody said no until it got down and kept going over and over. And you finally got something good.
Yeah, well, and
that's why it's saying here, you're talking about this plan. This is a third plan. Okay, maybe it's not good. Maybe we're going to have to go to a fourth plan.
But what this plan did, which the other ones didn't do, is we started off at $3-4 million. Yeah. Now we've got
higher. It was higher the first time.
Oh yeah, well, yeah. But I'm
that's
saying,
my point.
It was a lot, and what you now have is an architect working with you to say, if you get $50,000 for accessibility, spend $50,000. If you now have another chunk of money, in this case $880,000, which could be split into other things that you do, you may not do them all, but if you can find $800,000, you can do these things, and then there's some other things that you can get into the millions, but you don't have to do those. You can do this one. And because you're only doing this one, you don't trip over the sprinkler systems and all the electrical and all the extra that would cost you a whole bunch
of money. But you got to have that formulated down so people know exactly where it's going to go.
Yep.
You can't keep saying we're going to do this and that and this, change this. You know, you got to have a formula to exactly what you're going to do and how it's going to be and how much it's going to cost.
Well, and I would then turn to the study that Mass Historical paid for, because that's where the grant money came from.
Yeah.
What we're talking about is the next phase of bricks and mortar.
Well, what they will fund. They put dollar amounts to every phase, and the only issue is that dollar amount, the large part of it is labor. And we don't know the numbers for labor. I don't think it's worked out that way, is it? Do they have labor numbers in there?
Estimates of what the all in would be to do it. Yes.
But is it itemized for labor? All right, because I didn't look that deep into it. I'm more plan oriented. I'm looking at the plan and moving forward.
That's what I'm hearing. People don't like the plan.
So basically, you take out construction, carpentry, labor, and you take out electrical labor, and that's going to be the bottom line.
We got to educate some folks.
Educate or just I think.
Educate.
I think they need to. I think they know need to know what is going to actually take place here,
that's
and how much it's going to cost, and what are we going to have when we're done.
Yep.
Those are what we need to know.
Yeah. You know? And again. You had a grant that Mass Historical paid for to educate it. At least we're educated now that we've gone through it. Need to go deeper, but we're educated as to what's going on. Now we need to have everybody else understand anyway what it says. They can vote no at the end of that, sure, but at least understand. I mean, the document's an inch thick.
And we can't keep, you know, coming up with more and more plans. I mean, this
one. Actually, I like this one.
I like
because,
this one myself.
Because it allows you to do a piece at a time.
It's in phases.
And I'm suggesting that we take the next hunk after the $50,000 and look about finding money to do that phase, because we can find 30% of that phase being paid for by Mass Historical again.
And we lose sight of the fact that Mr. Simpson put together an organization that trying to raise money for this building.
Yes, as well.
Yeah, I understand all that, but you got to look at the whole scope, the dollars and cents, the taxpayers, what we're going to end up in, and is it going to be
everyone in this room?
Is it going to be functional, and what it's going to cost? The whole everything.
Everyone in this room except one person pays taxes to this town of Brookfield. Correct. I think we all have a...
Bro?
Karen, unfortunately, she unfortunately doesn't live in town.
Look, you're getting her all red.
But,
I knew where you were going.
We all have a vested interest in keeping our property taxes low.
Yes, exactly.
But at the same time, this building has to function.
And we're failing as far as that topic goes right now.
I would disagree, but...
Mr. Chairman?
Yes, sir.
Any chance that you could put some kind of an information package and make it available to people before the hearing?
We'll discuss that at the next meeting.
Great idea.
And then where to pick it up and all that kind of... And then where to pick it up and all that kind of thing.
You know, since it... this is a beautiful building.
It is.
And since, you know, we've got the police station, everything's all cleaned out now, the trees, you can see it from Route 9. It's beautiful down here, and we have to do something with it. And it would be nice even to get some kind of a spotlight, even just the back, you know, light it up so people can see.
Dave mentioned people within this building that don't like the plan. You know, those same people want this building destroyed. You know, we've heard that. There's been ideas of just leveling this building and putting up a one-story building. So, speaking of the devil. All right, so we'll do that.
Good.
Item number 8, Mr. Snyder requested for this to be on the agenda. Floor is yours, sir.
This is...
Did you want to chime in? We're going to have a public hearing, and it's going to be a yay or nay of moving forward with renovating this town hall.
A public hearing?
Correct.
Yep.
Not a town meeting?
No.
Eventually.
We'll need a town meeting if we need money, if we move forward. But this is just to say yay or nay. Do we like the plan? Do we want to move forward with it? And moving forward with that means renovating the assessor's office into the woman's bathroom.
Okay. When do you plan?
We're going to look into grants. Mr. Simpson's meeting with Mr. Scanlon on Tuesday. We'll have more information there for financial issues. And then at our next selectmen's meeting, we'll set a public hearing date.
Okay, so my only concern coming in tonight was I thought you all might be making a decision to get on this now and use the assessor's office and make that happen. My only concern was, well, I had plenty of concerns, but when you approach this and you start doing construction work on the assessor's office, what's your plan for the assessors? Where are they going to go?
There's been discussion to keep them right at this desk here and keep records in the other room. There's been discussion of keeping them in the other room. There's been discussions of relocating Betty, possibly relocating the zoning enforcement officer and building inspector. And
they put the assessors in there in the meantime?
In my mind, we have one assessor. Which is good. So we only have to house one individual. The others, they've met out here for meetings. They can still meet out here. To me, the biggest issue is files.
I just think that when that time comes, you know, we finally make a decision regarding this, is that you consult with the assessors and the other town employees. And I suppose having that public hearing may be part of that discussion. I think we really want to make sure we have a concrete plan, make sure that records are safe and that everything's stable, which... That's kind of unlikely, but we can try, right?
I think they're pretty stable now.
Mm-hmm.
All we need is a locked door, or we don't even need a locked door, just some locked file cabinets.
Mm. Most of them, I think everybody has.
You know yourself, they got into a locked vault. If someone wants to get into something, they're going to get into something.
Yeah. Yep.
I was here when they even got into a locked vault that was... That was locked.
That's the biggest. Yep. Most secure location in this building, and they still got into it.
Yep.
Nothing's impenetrable.
If someone wants it bad enough, they're going to get it.
Right. Okay, that's all I had.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks for bringing back the subject.
Not a problem.
Thanks, Mike.
Floor is now yours, Mr. Snyder.
Great. We're going to talk Brookfield Community Media for the moment. I had the opportunity to meet with the current committee. And I think we need to recognize the three members of the committee that are holding the activities together and moving things forward. But what we really have to do is solicit the town for those folks that might want to join that committee. The committee's strength needs to be 7. It is at 3 at the moment.
Okay.
So we really do need to highlight the need for 4 additional people to join the committee.
So I'm going to look at the camera again. Mr. Snyder's put it in the Citizen. We've talked to you guys several times. I don't mean to be mean, or maybe that's just my disposition, but if you are not interested yourself, you know, maybe your grandchildren, maybe your children,
This is an opportunity, in a world of YouTube, everybody's videotaping everything, this is a perfect opportunity to volunteer. It's all about time. You know, Ms. Mahoney comes out here on her own time, she videotapes these events, she goes back to the studio and she processes them, and like Mr. Snyder said, there's only three of them doing that. Even if we can get out and videotape these, give her something else to do, spend some time with her family. To me, it's an enjoyable thing to do. I took a production class in college. I loved it. I made many productions. Get involved. To me, this is an ideal situation.
And so I'll give you a couple of examples. So we have
studio. So please, please contact either Ms. Mahoney, Mr. Snyder, if you like him more, or Karen's a very friendly individual, 867-2930, extension 10. Please, we're begging you.
Yes, and there are a couple of skills that we need. We need someone to help build out the studio, work on the studio. So if we had a mechanical contractor kind of person that wanted to help with the building out of the studio, we have money available. The good news of working with Charter is we pay fees for Charter and they get returned to the town, fortunately. So with that, there's some dollars to be spent on the studio to improve the studio. The second is another example where the bulletin might be available to. And I use the stay-at-home mom thing for just an idea, because I happen to have an experience where I was the president of Hamilton Rod and Gun Club, mm-hmm. and a gal took some time off to have a family, yeah. and when she did that, she didn't want to have a discontinuity in her skills or resume, so she became the treasurer of the club, and she was doing all the treasury stuff for us, and quite honestly, improved what we were doing. And so this is another example with the community media, where we have the bulletin board that needs to continue to be maintained. There's some skills of learning how to do that. And if there's someone who wants to build out a resume, perfect way to do that and work with the committee. So there's a couple of skill sets that the committee could in fact use. Now, we talked a bit also about filming and paying for filming and the like. We also see $7,000 to $11,000, and I'm looking at Sharon to make sure I get this thing right, $7,000 to $11,000 gets returned to the town for expenses. But they expect, Charter expects to be paying for the filming providing dollars, expense dollars to pay for people to do some filming. The current rate around here is this $35 per meeting that we talked about. And so that would entail someone picking up the equipment, coming, doing the taping, returning the equipment. So it's a couple hours, maybe more, depending on the length of the meeting, that they would be in fact paid. There is money. It is not coming out of town pocket. It's actually fees like the fees I pay that we want good service. We want, and what we used to have was six recorders, and we now have the ability to have like 250 programs. So you just need to have them being taped, and this is a way to do that. So I would encourage I would encourage us to talk about the idea of paying for service, and that we would accept that under the leadership of the cable committee, that they in fact institute a program, a practice, to in fact increase the numbers of programs that we have. And again, getting back to your earlier point, train some young folks to be able to do this.
It'd be nice if we could get some of the media students from Tantascor over the summer.
Well, that's where his dollar amount. I have a really bad taste in my mouth. We had this discussion about volunteer firefighters, on-call firefighters. Mm-hmm. We've had the discussion, anybody running into a burning building, not getting compensated for it, that's the truest definition of volunteerism. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. you can call it on-call. I'm going to continue to call it volunteer firefighters.
Mm-hmm.
And thank you for what you do, for our firefighters out there. But it's the volunteer situation. I just, bad taste wanting to pay someone to come out and videotape something.
And I'm only saying that it's a routine that's available to us, and it may be a way to encourage service. So we'll see how we get numbers of volunteers to be able to do this.
So besides outreach through meetings like this that get posted on 194, what else can we do? Have we gone to Facebook and asked?
I haven't, but that's certainly an opportunity. We Sharon's saying that she has.
She has.
We may need to be doing some more. But again, we're out tonight.
When you discussed with Tantascor, did you see if any of their students were Brookfield residents?
Yeah. We happen to have one that is available to us, and we've made no. Right now, it's volunteer. would like to have this conversation tonight, and if we don't decide
so tonight. So can we reach out to that family to see if they're willing to volunteer?
Oh, I very gladly.
Do you have access to that?
I do.
Would you be willing to?
Oh, yeah. He did the soundboard at the church last summer for me for volunteering.
Maybe through Boy Scouts?
We could. Probably a little young because of that group, but certainly I can ask. I can ask Brian. Sure. No problem. I can ask.
Can we reach out to Lindsay as well for a Facebook post as well?
I already wrote it down.
Okay. So now we do it. We don't have to settle that tonight other than it is an opportunity. And if
I would just tell people get on board.
Yep.
If I had the time, it's one of the best things around. It's fun. You go out to events.
Yep.
That's what makes Brookfield Brookfield, yeah. Are those events. And to be part of a videotaping it and put it on TV, that's huge.
Yep. So we'll see where it goes. But again, I would encourage you because the funds are there, the expense dollars are there to pay for it. If we have to do that, then that's something we need to consider.
Bring some cotton candy before we talk about it again.
Okay, I'll get you some cotton candy. Not a problem. We do have one administrative thing that I'd suggest that the board recommend Karen follow up with Betty. Works out that the funds are received in two pockets, from two pockets, one being equipment, expense, hardware kinds of things, and expense kinds of things like, Sharon, you're going to have to help me. We have the $50,000 that we received, and that goes towards new equipment and the studio. And then we have another, the $7,000 to $11,000 worth of expense kinds of things that would be fees for
salaries,
different
stipends, maintain the HVAC system we installed last year.
Yep.
Charter charge for our internet connection, electric bills. If the electric bills get bumped up on the new equipment that we've installed, and we're in conversations with Kathleen Hostin about that to monitor that situation. Expenses, for example, if we potentially hire a part-timer sometime in the future to actually run the studio on an ongoing basis. Consumables, batteries, SD cards for the camera, toilet paper, those types of things.
Yeah, there's two buckets, and what happened is we, for some reason, combined them, and they shouldn't have been combined, because if we were to be audited.
I thought Betty took care of that half a year ago.
I thought she did that
with Jim.
Brought
them together, and they're not separate yet.
Because Jim brought that issue up to us.
Okay.
That might have been with Mr. Thomo when he was on board.
We got to split them. So
it's in the contract.
Yeah. I thought we took care of that one.
I was under the understanding, too, that was taken care of.
Just wondering
so
can you reach out to Betty and make sure that gets done. And I had one more. What was the one more, Sharon? Oh, the internet connection of the building to bring fiber into the building.
This building or that building?
This building.
All right.
To bring so that this could actually go live.
Yep.
And so the idea would be, or what we talked about for the idea, is to bring the wire into the basement, somewhere in the basement, and then bring it up.
Well, she was supposed to be working with Scott Mansfield to make it attractive.
I think he was. Last I heard, Scott was supposed to be working.
I'll reach out to Scott to see.
Could you? That would be great. But the idea would be bring fiber into the basement and then bring it up
because
somewhere.
If you remember correctly, she came in, and anybody that's had cable installed in an older building, they just run it. It's quick in and out, as quick as they can do it, as cheap as they can do it. It looks horrible, and we don't want this to this building.
We need to keep this and room as best for
Mr. Mansfield has volunteered to assist.
Yeah, if you could do that, that would be great.
So I'll follow up with Scott on that.
But actually, again, tonight. I want to thank Sharon and the group for all that they're doing.
I'd like to thank, I appreciate it too, all that they do. It's only three of them, like you say, that are maintaining the studio down there, and I appreciate that
everybody.
Very much.
Any other discussion?
That's it.
Other, there is no other, but there is correspondence. The Commonwealth of Massachusetts Department of Public Utilities, there is a public hearing by law, and that this is the second time we've gone out. They're obligated to let us know, and we're just reminding people that you have to submit comments to the department no later than the close of business at 5 p.m. April 14th, 2016. And any person that wishes to participate in the evidentiary phase of the process must file a written petition by March 30th, which is coming up a couple days, so time is ticking.
Mr. Stendrup responded to a citizen. I'll read this, right, so I don't paraphrase it. My name is Michael Creighton. My family and I live at 92 Rice Corner Road in Brookfield. In January, a road crew took down a large tree near our driveway, greatly improved our line of sight from the end of the driveway. We want to thank the crew for a great job they did cutting a tree at a very low height. We saw Clarence Snyder's column regarding making wood the wood available to those who could burn or sell it. We have no interest in the wood, and this again goes back to our policy. Once again, thanks for making the roadway safer for us. Good job, Michael Creighton. And that's nice to hear. Mm-hmm. This is just FYI for this board, the fire department. I thought we brought this up at the last one.
That was old. That was just
okay. You're familiar with the chief's request for that.
Yeah.
All right. Any other business before the board this evening?
Time to go home.
Hearing none, I will entertain a motion to adjourn at 7:06.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second it.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.